Yeah, no doubt. Well, there's no one ruining your time, Cousin Shane, and that's because Tennessee just landed five-star quarterback commit Nico Iamaleava. I'm sure I butchered that right there, but if you don't,
Bob Kessler's going to love that one. You're talking about getting a nickname real quick.
If you don't know it by now, he's the number 7 overall prospect in the country, number 3 quarterback, I believe. And he's coming to Tennessee. Shane, gives Tennessee right now a top 10 recruiting class. And every team in the top 10 has more commits than Tennessee, other than Ohio State and Tennessee only have 5 apiece, yet they're both in the top 5. That gives you an indication of the caliber of commitments those two programs have. But this is just a game changer on so many levels, Shane, because as Tennessee continues to rise up the SEC ladder under Josh Heupel, you know, you could have the greatest coach in the world, but you cannot get it done in the SEC without the talent. And it all starts with that quarterback who, I don't know if you saw this, Shane, but 24/7 Sports, their West Coast director of recruiting, Greg Biggins, says Nico, Tennessee commitment, he's his number 1 overall quarterback, and he thinks if he has another great season of high school football, there's an outstanding chance he is the number 1 overall prospect in the country. This is a guy that I believe has only played 2 seasons of high school football. He's one of these guys that plays all the sports, Shane. He could go anywhere in the country to go play volleyball. He just plays a number of sports, and he's just an all-around athlete. And, you know, like I said, just a couple of years of football, yet Alabama, Georgia, Clemson, USC, UCLA, Oregon, all these schools wanted him. How big is this for the Tennessee program landing arguably the top quarterback in the country?
Mike, I mean, it's huge. I think, did you send me the crazy stat that Tennessee hasn't landed a 5-star quarterback in, what was it, 20 years or something like that?
Yeah, Casey Clawson in 2002 was the last time.
Yeah, so, I mean, think about that, man. It's 20 years since we've had a legit 5-star quarterback come through here. And I think it's just big for us because you're talking about a true athlete, somebody that fits that Heupel system to a T. I mean, it's pretty much designed for a kid like Nico. Now, obviously, there's a lot of controversy floating around this kid, but I'm telling you, he looks the part, man. He looks Hollywood, brother. He looks like he's ready to come out here and sign some more NIL deals when he lands in Knoxville. So, brother, I'm pumped. I'm ecstatic because one thing, too, when you land somebody like that, who does he bring with him? You know, every time you hear this kid talk online, he's always reaching out to other kids. I mean, this is one of those things that can pick up steam for the university. This is one of those things that could lead to more recruits coming down. And that's what you want, man. You just want to become the hot team. You want to be the favorite team, the one that all the kids want to play for. And it all starts with a good quarterback. And like you said, I think we got one of the best, if not the best in the country.
Yeah, and that's an interesting place to take at, Shane. I want to do just a little flashback to last week. We had Coach Carl Reed on the show, 24/7 sports analyst, state champion high school coach from the state of Missouri, who's been following this recruitment on Nico and what his commitment would mean to Tennessee and its recruiting class. Let's cut back to this clip real quick if you missed it. The 5-star out of California, Nico. You know, there's speculation that Tennessee rising up the charts. I know you covered that specifically. What can you tell us, the audience, about Nico and his massive potential, potentially, in Josh Heupel's offense?
Well, number one, he can make all the throws, right? And so when you're talking about a kid like him who can play quarterback for anybody in the country and who has the leadership ability and a word that not many people use anymore, I might show my age a little bit, he's got a lot of moxie. Right. He's got a little bit of swagger to him. And you have to have that kind of confidence to come in the SEC and win the games you're going to win. If you're thinking about playing at the University of Tennessee, you're going to have to go into Georgia and win. If you want to win the SEC East, you're going to have to go into Florida and win. You're going to have to play the cross conference games with the SEC West schools. And so you need a big-time quarterback in some of those situations to take you over the top. But win, lose, or draw, nobody has consistently, maybe the fan base that the University of Tennessee has, 100,000 fans screaming Rocky Top, no matter what the program is doing. So I think it's a unique situation. Josh Heupel has proven year after year during his times as offensive coordinator at Oklahoma and Missouri, the places he's been, Central Florida, now Tennessee, he's an elite offensive coach. And if he can close the deal on Nico, it's going to put some pressure on some of the SEC defense.
And do you think Nico, just what you know about him, is he the type of guy where you can really build an entire class around him because other players are going to want to play with a guy that has that swagger, has that moxie?
Well, definitely. I talk to recruits all the time, and I don't care what position you play. I don't care if you're a linebacker, a D lineman, whatever you are. If you want to win games and compete for championships, you need to pay attention to where the best quarterbacks are going, because at the end of the day, the guys with elite quarterback play, with a few exceptions. You know, Georgia showed this year that you can do without it if you have that type of generational defense. But more times than not, if you have an elite quarterback, you're going to give yourself a chance to win football games.
All right, Shane. So, hey, again, that's from Coach Carl Reed on the show last week. And I wanted to play that, Shane, because immediately after Nico committed to Tennessee, you got five-star receiver Carnell Tate. You know, he was pumping up the Vols. This is a key target that Nico says he's going to try to bring to Tennessee. Four-star receiver Kyler Casper from Arizona. That's another guy Nico says he's going to try to bring to Tennessee. And four-star receiver Devin Hyatt from South Carolina, who is, of course, the brother, younger brother of Tennessee receiver Jalen Hyatt. He also reacted to it. And Carnell Tate and Devin Hyatt, they both play right now for IMG Academy down there in Florida. So, hey, they're together. You got to imagine they're talking about this. And this could be, you know, basically the snowball that gets things rolling here for Tennessee. I already said they got a top 10 class right now, but they have very few prospects committed. This could be a snowball to an elite class, don't you think?
Oh, absolutely, man. Like I said, look, you got two kids on the IMG right now that are talking about the University of Tennessee. Well, it's not like these two kids don't know the rest of the players on that team, or don't know a freshman that's maybe not as big, but, you know, you're always looking up to these guys that are thinking about going to the college level or the pro levels, you know? Mm-hmm. So I think it is big. It's momentum. It's a pipeline you create. And it's there, like I said, I'm sure we're going to talk about it, but there is that aspect of the NIL floating around. There's a lot of people that don't like the idea that you pay players. Brothers, ladies and gentlemen, they've been paying players since the 70s, the 60s, the 50s. You know what I'm saying? These guys get money. Don't worry about that. This is the first outlet that we've had where we've had a NIL, I guess, $8 million contract. Absolutely. Is he worth $8 million? You better believe it. If he starts winning, if he helps this team win SEC championships, national championships, look what Alabama has created down there in Tuscaloosa. It is an absolute money machine. Mm-hmm. You know, Alabama has always been a winning program, but what Nick Saban has done to that program has quadrupled the amount of profits they make, man. I mean, you go to any state, you're going to see Alabama gear in Walmart. You know what I'm saying? It's like America's team, college team. So that's what happens. Winning creates that type of atmosphere. So, yeah, you see an $8 million price tag. Absolutely, kid's worth it, if not more. In fact, what I love about it is all these kids are talking about how much money Nico's going to make. Do you think they ain't going to want the same type of deal when they go to their universities? Or you don't think they're going to want the same deal if they come to University of Tennessee? Man, Tennessee's paying right now. So, absolutely. I think this is huge for our program, huge for momentum. And I know it blows some of these reports. I've seen so many hot opinions online, brother. Everybody's got opinion of this $8 million NIL deal. But to think that we're the only school in the country doing this, you're out of your damn mind. I'm going to tell you right now, Mike, if you think $8 million is a lot, you wait till Arch signs with somebody and look at that NIL. I'm telling you what, it's going to blow $8 million right out of the water.
Yeah, when I was on Paul Feinbaum, that's something he was asking me about. And I said, you know, $5 to $10 million is what I'd anticipate for old Arch. And you know, that kind of blew his mind, but we're seeing it come to fruition here, Shane. I mean, that's what it's going to take. And, you know, it is interesting that you say that, Shane, because, you know, already starting to see there's the Florida lawyer who handles NIL for the Florida Gators. I think he does Miami Hurricanes as well, but I mean, he's basically going out to try to ruin this. There's Dennis Dodd over at CBS. He's out here writing about this and how this is illegal and wrong and all this, but it's just, hey, I mean, it's just, it is what it is. You know, if someone's willing to pay this much for a player, then they're worth it. Mm-hmm. And this is all legal now. And, you know, is Dennis Dodd going to turn down $8 million if ESPN turns around and says, hey, you know, this is how much I'll pay you to leave CBS? Hell no. You know, he's taking that money and running. So, I don't know. I think it's hypocritical for anybody. And here's another good point I saw a lot of people make was, you know, for years and years, the sports writers, the media, they really pushed, you know, we've got to let these players get their piece of the pie. Now, all of a sudden, it's too much. Like, hey, they're not worth this. But, like, you can't have it both ways. You know, you got to let the market set the value. And I'm not saying that every quarterback is worth $8 million because for a program like Tennessee, they need that shot in the arm. They need that momentum. They need that juice. Does Alabama need that right now? Does Georgia need that? Hell no. They've been dominating. But, you know, at the end of the day, if that's what the market says someone's worth, you know, I'm just kind of – I understand it's a high figure and it's blowing people's minds, but – you know, you said it perfectly. I mean, Alabama's a money-making machine down there, and it's because they have so many elite players, because they're winning on the field consistently week in and week out. And if this kid lives up to his potential, I mean, Tennessee's getting the deal of a lifetime here.
Oh, dude, without a doubt, man. And you think this is crazy? Come see me in 5 years, Mike. This is just the tip of the iceberg. This is like when I went to Olive Garden when I was younger, and I got two kids, right? Mm-hmm. And so the youngest one has the ability to use these tablets. So when she'd go to the Olive Garden or one of them fancy restaurants, she could get on there and she could play. And we took her out to eat. You know what I'm saying? The oldest one didn't have that, and she was mean as hell. So I didn't want to take her to the to any of the restaurants. You know what I'm saying? We just didn't eat out. Terrible twos went to threes and fours. You know what I'm saying? But then when that tablet came out, it became a deal. You know, I was like, man, it blew my mind that this was sitting there on the table and the kids could play games. Why didn't we think of this? And then now you go, every kid in the world has got a tablet. You know what I'm saying? Not just in the restaurant, but they got them everywhere. So I say that to say this, you know, you look at $8 million into your, right now it's blowing your mind, but you're going to look 5 years from now, brother, and this thing is going to snowball. We're going to be talking about kids making more money than coaches. We're going to be talking about kids making more money than some of the players in the NFL. It is coming, guys. And if you're not ready for it, then what have you been doing? You should have been prepared. We've been talking about this for 2 years. We knew it was coming. And and like I said, Nico's not the only one to get paid. Well, what about the Notre Dame kid? Got $1 million, right? Nobody. I mean, we're not going to talk about that. That's not national media because it's not quite enough, you know? So I think this is just – this is the beginning. And we're going to have to – we're going to have to embrace it. And I told you, I don't know if you remember, Mike, but I told you last season that the teams that embrace this NIL first are going to be the next powerhouses in the SEC. Mm-hmm. So, and I look at teams like Texas A&M. I look at teams like Arkansas that are taking these NIL deals seriously, and they are creating something from the ground up. They are going to be just like Tennessee. The ones that are taking – because, like you said, Alabama, Georgia, maybe Florida, you know, they kind of got a little bit of a pipeline to the NFL anyway. You know, and you can give the spiel, hang out for a couple years, you're going to make millions. But now you can go somewhere else and make millions while you wait. And if you're around good enough players, you're going to be at the top of the food chain, you know. So I don't know. I just think we're getting a glimpse now of the future, and it's just, you think today blows your mind, just like I said, wait till next year, wait till 3 years from now.
Yeah, and if nothing else, Shane, the McDonald's bags are legal now. You know what, brother?
Come on now. Come on, Pruitt up there in New York, be like, damn it, you know? I should have played ball, you know? I should have shook hands and kissed babies just one more year. But yep. Anyway, no. But, hey, I'll tell you, brother, this is a big deal, but it's not going to be the biggest deal this year. You just wait and see. There's going to be some more of these NILs. They're just figuring out, guys. And just when you see it, there's going to be people that, like this Florida lawyer, there's going to be people that poke holes in it. And that just means the next time that they put one of these contracts together, it's going to be stronger. It's going to be easier for them to get out of. So it's the next generation college football. Some people hate it. You know, I'm for the longest time, I didn't like the idea, but, you know, again, you got to remember, it's 20 years since we had a five-star quarterback. So now I'm like, you know what? I'm coming around to this thing, you know? Now, somebody offers him 10 and he goes somewhere else. I'm going to say, shut it down, tear it up.